Okay, this is a quick summary of what we have learned so far about how to use the acoustimeter to measure radio frequency fields. Turning on the meter is simple. If you're a beginner, I recommend that you mostly work with peak measurements. There's two types of measurements the meter makes, peak and average. So we're looking over on the meter here on the left column of LEDs. We're looking at peak levels versus average. If you wanted to look in the display to find the level in the moment, you can see up here in this meter, this meter is reading 2.45 volts per meter as a peak right in this moment. If you wanted to know what is the highest peak that the meter has seen since it's been turned on, you would look in the parentheses in the upper left, in this case 5.29, again volts per meter. That's the what we call the maximum peak. So when you start taking measurements, the easiest thing to do is begin by watching the LEDs under the peak column on the left and get some idea of generally what the levels are. Then if you want to see exactly what the measurement is, you can look in the display, and again in the upper right, that would be the peak level at the moment wherever you're holding the meter. Here you see it in this case, 2.45 volts per meter. And it's always good to put your measurements on a data sheet because you can really easily forget and confuse numbers later. I tend to use two columns. So for the radio frequencies, in the units of volts per meter, I tend to make one column for typical peak, we call it, and another column for maximum peak. The typical peak is what I would call the typical measurements that I'm measuring. For instance, around the room or in the chair of your computer or on the couch where you watch TV. As you move the meter around, what are the normal measurements you're getting? Sometimes you'll get higher measurements and lower measurements. There might be high spikes. We're just looking, what's the typical level you're getting? That versus the maximum peak, where what is the highest peak level that was measured during that time period? If you want to find the maximum peak, you can see that in the upper left-hand corner of the display in the parentheses. And basically, that'll show you the strongest peak that's been measured since the meter was last turned on. Again, this is called the maximum peak, or sometimes peak hold. And here you can see on this case, it's 5.29 volts per meter is the measurement of the maximum peak since the meter was turned on. And I would write that under the maximum peak column on my data sheet. I would write 5.29 in this case if I was entering that onto the data sheet. For instance, on this sheet where we have the master bedroom, the maximum peak we had was 0.03, a fairly low level. Another case in the family room, we had a maximum of 0.32 volts per meter. So I'd write that in there. Even though the typical level in the family room was normally much smaller, very low, 0.02, this shows that at some time, or fairly frequently, we don't know, but at some point, there was a higher peak measurement gained, and that was the maximum, and we record that. That can be very helpful later. And if you want to take another maximum peak, for instance, you've done the maximum peak of your bedroom, and now you want to do one in your living room, all you need to do is turn the meter off and then on again, and it'll reset to start with a new maximum peak. And finally, one of the most helpful features of this meter is the audio function. There's a volume control on the right side of the meter here, and you can turn that up or down, and basically that will take some of the digital modulated frequencies, electronically turn them into a sound that you can hear. And that's very helpful because you'll hear the distinctive sounds associated with the different kinds of radio frequency sources. So you can learn to tell the difference between a cell tower, from a smart meter, from a decked cordless phone, from a Wi-Fi router, and that can be really helpful to help you determine sources. And also very helpful, for instance, if you have a particular sound like a chit-chit-chit-chit kind of thing, you suspect it's the router, a Wi-Fi router, say, unplug the router and that distinctive sound all of a sudden disappears simultaneously, you've just confirmed with the audio function that that was that particular source. Very helpful.